back in 2005, we were all so energized by having our children here, and we had pretty boundless energy and enthusiasm. This trip in particular takes an enormous amount of physical and emotional energy, which is diminishing now at age 72. I mean, you need to be moving right way early.
So it looks like they're going through that white foam.
The whole deal is right at the top.
Yeah.
Seeing where that place is. And you know, if you're comfortable going backwards, that's the power.
Luckily we got far enough left that the rock, we were on the left rocks of that rock island. It wasn't, you know, if we had gone right into the middle of those rocks, it would have been helicopter rescue time. There's no way we would have gotten off of them. And ultimately, I think we wouldn't have gotten off of there unless John had come up in his kayak and added the strength that we needed.
My sense with Sean is that he's at the height of his adolescent ego development, and he's going to put on an air of strength and macho and piece of cake through the whole trip. But I also think that behind that, he has a healthy fear and a deep respect for the power of the water.
But the river, really, to me, is the thread that's run through all three of us and kind of kept us connected, because then I learned to guide. I decided I have to really learn to guide. I want to do this.
It became a family.
Well, it really has introduced the whole community aspect of raising children. You know, I don't have blood family here. I need to create the family that's going to help me raise my children.
It's a little bit windy. We just got out to the Grand Canyon. We're rigging boats tomorrow. 12-person group, 24-day trip. Probably not going to sleep a ton tonight.
Lee's Ferry. I mean, this is just the start.
How beautiful it is, you know, dealing with an immense amount of beauty down here. And at the same time, it's a very harsh trip.
Yeah, you never know exactly how the puzzle's gonna fit together.
I'm the Poopmaster.
I'm the Poopmaster. All right, it's an important job.
Where are we headed?
I don't know.
Critical.
A lot like sand.
You know, I'm not on a team in much things in my adult life. When I was a kid, I was part of the athletic teams, but it's definitely a big part of the joy of this. Because at 73, I realized I'm very fortunate to have the strength to do this now. It's not going to last. So it's something we talk about is, when are we going to become liabilities rather than assets on these trips? So it's embracing impermanence, and that's not easy.
Mm-hmm.
have to get some.
You're excited.
It's a Rick specialty. Plus, there's whipped cream.
Amazing. We were just saying it's like bluer than blue, bluer than we remember. Because there hasn't been any rain up above. This is all water out of the spring, the center of the world for the Hopi Nation. Let's see Papu.
Day 7. We're headed up. Scout Hans, one of the bigger rapids on the Grand Canyon.
I'm not sure you can get very far left. Yeah. I would just do it right here in Vernon.
Right around 20,000 CFS.
And it's Rick's 77th birthday today.
I need to do the things that I enjoy and things that make me happy with the time I have left. Maybe late 60s that I kind of went, you know, we're running out of time here, dude.
I feel fortunate that I've had a life that's not been sedentary.
Made it to Crystal Rapid. I don't know if you guys can see it, but they're basically wrapped on the gravel bar right there. And that's like pretty much the worst spot to be.
The timing is everything on crossing over and breaking through those laterals.
Have you been out there? It's a very scary thing. And there's nothing we can do to help them, huh?
I mean, all the yellow boats had it.
This place starts at hard and then goes from there. And you know, it sounds like a cliche and a joke, but that's, I think people have seen this. It's a harsh environment. Plan A never works. And I think in our lives, we want things fixed and known. And I can't tell you how many times I said, this is my last trip. But when I'm out here, I just find the openness opens me more.
Day 9. I would be lying if I didn't say that I'm not broke off tired. But these old guys, they freaking push it.
These quartz veins, these are crazy.
Oh, getting my tent up and getting into dry clothes. Oh, that was a highlight, for sure. You know, finding my sunglasses after I couldn't find them. A lot of little highlights.
We have a lot of low bars here.
First, we want to figure out where we are in the water cycle and then get a strategy for doing the least amount of work possible.
This is not the low, regardless.
Day 14.
Really cool waking up on the water though.
Looks pretty rowdy. We hit this one straight.
It all worked out. Nobody flipped. Yeah.
We are jamming down to mile 279, which is about 1 mile above takeout, which will happen tomorrow. What this section down to Pierce Ferry is really showing me is that there's a ton of work that has to be done to make this ecosystem actually healthy. This whole layer you can see is all silt built up from the 1980s when Lake Mead was full. And now you can kind of see over time, as well as drought, that the lake has gone down substantially and is only going to continue to do so. With all the beauty that's stacked on top of it, we're passing through a very disrupted ecosystem. Crazy to sleep on the boat last night, be hearing these big pieces of silt breaking off and splashing into the river. So the depressing fact is that the Grand Canyon hasn't reached the ocean in a very long time. That was it. We just exited the Grand Canyon. The silt banks were a sobering reminder of that every resource comes with a price. And we all use them. Fresh water, pretty high demand and extremely valuable commodity out here in the desert.
I think until I'm really fearless, I can't claim to be free of the fear of death. It's gonna be a great event for me and a sad event for others. So it's, you know, I like to view it as part of the mystery and part of the ultimate adventure.